Hello and welcome to the third day of Espresso Developer Conference. I am very excited to welcome you here, and we at Espresso are happy to be part of such vibrant community of developers, both enthusiasts and professionals. So let's explore the world of ESP32 today. In early days of Espresso, if you ask me which chip to choose, the answer will be simple. It would be just ESP8266. Since those days, many new chips were developed and are available on the market. For a beginner, it might be quite confusing which chip to choose. So let me give you some guidance. Let's start with ESP32S3. ESP32S3 is part of this ESP32S3 box 3, and it allows additional PSRAM, so it's suitable also for a project that requires GUI. It's also part of other development kits like M5 Stack Core S3. But what if your solution is battery operated? In that case, I would go for ESP32C6, which has support for Wi-Fi 6 and has low power core, which is using very low current. But as you can see, there are many more chips available. So how to choose from them? Our team at Espresso put together product selector available at products.espresso.com. Let's explore product selector. Let's navigate to espresso.com, hardware and product selector. On the left side, we can see different features that we can use for filtering, and you can choose for your project like Wi-Fi support, Bluetooth support, Thread and Zigbee support. There is also marketing status, which indicates whether the chip is produced and available on the market, like the mass production, or whether chip was phased out and is no longer available, like EOL means end of life. So let's select ESP32S3. Here you can find more details about the chips, like memories, voltage, communication interfaces, security features, and temperature range. You can use also further links like documentation and certification or development kits. Product selector has also support for comparison. Let's click here and let's compare two chips. In our case, we were talking about the S3, and let's compare it with C6. Now we can see the difference between those chips. This tool can help you to navigate through different offerings and help you to find correct chip for your project. Now we know how to choose the chip, but we will need far more information to start working with ESP32. Let me introduce you to the developer portal available at developer.espresso.com. The developer portal is available as a GitHub repo, so we invite community to contribute. So should you have an article, tutorial or workshop, please create a pull request. Let me show you how developer portal looks like. Let's go to developer.espresso.com. Here you can find developer portal. In the blog section, you can find several blog posts about various topics related to ESP32. ESP IDF. You can find here even article about coffee machine connected to the cloud using Rainmaker. If you'd like to contribute, the contribution guide is here. The document will guide you through all the questions and steps to creating the article. Adding new article is quite easy. Just fork the repository and then inside content block create a directory, and here you can use index markdown, which contains your article. So you write your article in the markdown format, and then after creating a pull request, it's merged to the main portal and published using the Hugo framework to the developer.espresso.com. We welcome contributions. Developer community is amazing at sharing knowledge. If you ask me about the tip that I learned from the community, I would definitely pick the video from Andreas Spies, the guy with the Swiss accent, and the video would be about the wire wrap. This simple tool that has been around for decades can really simplify the way how to prototype and how to create projects. So let me show you how it works. Let's connect this red wire to the board, to the pin. So let's strip the wire like this one. Now we can put it inside the wire wrap tool, put it into the pin, rotate, and it's holding. Now we can test whether it works. Yes, it's working. Now we can remove the wire. Just rotate the tool and rotate in opposite direction. As you can see, the wire was removed. Now we can test whether it's working. Yeah, it's not working. Let's switch from real wires to virtual wires. Thanks to simulator like Bokwi, it's possible to simulate ESP32 or even ESP32P4 in the web browser or IDE or continuous integration system. Today we will hear the talk about the Bokwi. Let me give you a sneak and peek. Let's open Bokwi at bokwi.com/ESP32. Here we can see featured projects created by community, also some starter templates and IDF templates. Let's select M5 Stack Core S3 and run the simulation. The simulation is running. Let's talk about programming, programming languages and technologies. First, we need to mention Arduino, which has huge community. It's well adopted on ESP32 chips. You can find many projects on GitHub and in open source world. So let's see how the Arduino works. Here we have Arduino IDE 2.3. We have selected ESP32 S3 box as our target. And here is the Arduino code. We just print the hello and then tic tac. So let's build the example and upload it to the board. Now compilation is done. Okay, firmware was written, so let's use the serial monitor. Should we connect and we can see hello ESP32 tic tac. Wonderful. So it's working. Now let's talk about C and C++. Here the choice is ESP IDF framework. ESP IDF is well supported on all ESP chips and can be used to develop professional projects. So majority of IoT solutions out there are using ESP IDF. So let's take a closer look how the build of ESP IDF project looks like. So let's build ESP IDF project. This one is located in examples, get started, hello world. First, let's make sure that we sourced ESP IDF. So we can do it by running this command. Now we can set the target. Since we are working with ESP32, it will be ESP IDF set target, ESP32 S3. And now we can type IDFpy build flash monitor. Very well, now it's flashing. And as we can see, the example in ESP IDF is working. Popularity of Rust programming language has been growing over past years. There is great community of developers and ESP32 chips are well supported, both in Rust STD, building on top of ESP IDF, and Rust non-STD, also known as bare metal. So it's up to you to choose whether to build on top of C framework or use pure Rust implementation with Rust bare metal. So let me show you how the build process looks like. To build a Rust project, we will use cargo command. So let's type cargo run --release. We recommend to use --release profile so the binary is smaller and execution on the MCU is faster. As you can see, Rust is compiling. And Rust produces binary, which can be flashed to the chip. Now we can choose the device and press enter.
and the flashing process is using ESP flash tool, which is also written in Rust. And here we can see the working application.
Arduino, C++ on top of ESP IDF, Rust. There are more programming languages that you can use with ESP32. So let's mention a few of them, like Python-based programming languages, MicroPython, or the Adafruit version of CircuitPython, both with great communities. Let's mention also Swift, that was announced during WWDC 2024. And also let's mention Zig, which is gaining popularity recently. And there are many more. Until this point, we were talking about programming languages and technologies. What about operating system? In case of ESP IDF, there is free RTOS underneath the whole framework. In case of bare metal, there is nothing, there is just bare metal. What about other operating systems available for ESP32? Well, there is Natix. Natix is very Linux-like system. You can write applications in many programming languages on top of it.
Then we definitely need to mention Zephyr,
which gained popularity in the industry and makes it easier to port applications between different embedded hardware. So definitely, you can check also these operating systems. I'd like to take a moment and thank community for great effort and for creating many interesting open source projects. And thanks to cooperation with Elector magazine, we were able to create a dedicated issue just to ESP32. So this is the issue December, January 2024. You can find here many ESP32 based projects. So Elector is a great source of information about ESP and new things that we are releasing. As we are exploring these programming languages and technologies, I encourage you to take a time, learn a new technology, and please, should you find something interesting, create a pull request to our developer portal and help us grow the knowledge available to the community. I wish you great experience at the third day of Espressive Developer Conference.